There's a lot of confusion about getting a Skoolie insured and titled, and I went through the entire process of having my vehicle retitled as an RV because it was important to me that I could get full coverage insurance. Now, every state is a little bit different, so it depends on where you live, but these were the steps I went through. So before getting it retitled, I used National General Insurance because it was my only option to cover Skoolies, and I was very happy with it. But they only did liability, and since I wanted full coverage insurance, I decided to go through the steps to have it retitled. So the first thing I did was I called my insurance provider for my car, and they told me all the steps I needed to go through, and it took some digging around. Like, this isn't really a common process. So the first thing I had to do was finish the conversion, and it has to meet, like, I can't remember, like 6 out of 10 certain criteria, such as running water, and it has to have a toilet, and you have to be able to cook, and it didn't have to meet all the criteria, it just had to meet most of them. So there's a good article that covers this a little bit more in detail from Skoolie Supply and some of the requirements, and I'll include a link there. So after I finished the conversion process, I had to go to the DMV and fill out an application for a title. And then I had to set up an appointment with the Highway Patrol. Now the Highway Patrol filled out the Form 108 to have the title transferred over because it was titled as a truck, even though it was technically a bus, and I wanted it to be an RV. So he did the inspection, which was kind of funny because he just poked his head in and looked around and said, "Yep, looks like an RV." So I guess it met the criteria. So he had to mail off that title form with my title, and I think there were a few other things like proof of my driver's license and stuff like that. It got mailed off. It took a long time to get it back, but once I got it back, I had the new title, which means I could get the full coverage insurance. So then I had to go back to my insurance provider with the new title. I had to take several pictures of the exterior and the interior, and then I was able to get full coverage insurance on my bus, and it is now officially titled as an RV. But remember, every state is a little bit different, and I recommend calling your insurance provider first because they'll probably be able to answer your questions better. And if you have any questions about the process, please let me know. Thanks!